This is Laura Jankowski. If you're not subscribed with Badass Rodeo Company, make sure to go ahead and be subscribed. Ding the bell so you don't miss any new cool stuff from us. And let's go ahead and get into it. Let's get started today. I really wanted to talk to you about REINS. Since it's nice and cold out today, let's talk some cool stuff that we can look online and buy. But anyways, as anything that I have and anything that I do, it's all important because it's all part of this barrel racing puzzle. And all of our equipment is just as important as anything else we do. So REINS is our communication between our hands and their mouth. So they're very important. And my favorite set of REINS are a heavy leather braided rein. And these ones are specifically made by Dale Wells. They are my favorite. They come in all different lengths. Because I do like a nice short rein because it's all a speed event, you know, so you don't want to be pulling way back here. And the reason I like these is they're nice and heavy for any type of, let's say we're turning like this, then I instantly have a reaction from my horse. And it's heavy enough where the rein's not going to flip over their head, and it's actually going to give you some pressure on the outside of the horse's neck that they're going to be able to feel during a run. So by far, these are my favorite. I'd also like to compare them and show you why. They're really the only type of reins that I'll use, and I suggest this at all my clinics as well. So if you've been to some of my clinics, you've heard me say this. So like the regular type of leather roping rein, to me, is too slippery, especially when we're at a high speed and we go to run and grab. We need that instant reaction. So this, guys, I am not a fan of. And then especially like the nylon braided reins, I really don't like those either. They're light. I've had this one, this specific set of reins, flop over my horse's head at state finals and cost me a championship. So I might use these on the trail, but not even then. I just kind of keep them around just because I hoard tech. Yeah, I don't even use them while I'm riding regularly because I want to get my horses the feel of leather across their neck. So I'll probably use a split rein while I'm trail riding or working a horse in the arena, and then I'll save my good Dale Wells reins on my competition day. There's also, you gotta watch when you're buying these braided reins. These are the... And the reason why I don't like them as much as the Dale Wells or something, or any type of competitor's rein, is because if you'll notice here, notice where the braiding is on the pink and where on the gray. See how much more braiding there is? So that if you need to reach down and pull, you still got braid. Well, this one doesn't seem like there's enough to me. And it seems like it's consistent across the board no matter how long you get them. You only get so much braiding. So that's why I like those reins. And I also, if you'll notice on all these, I take the clips off. And I'll put them straight to the bit. Just I have more contact that way. There's not something in between me and my horse's mouth, just the leather. And I have had the clips come undone on very intense horses, and it was extremely scary. So everything I'm telling you, there's definitely a reason, and I've made all the mistakes. And so please just trust me on this and stay safe with your horses. Be sure to go to badassrodeo.com where you can download your free booklet on perfect barrel pattern, and while you're at it, go ahead and check out some of our cool stuff. Like we have a book called Barrel Racing is Life to go ahead and track your progress and have success in your sport. So good luck everybody in 2020. Let me know what your favorite reins are in the comments. I want to hear them. Maybe some pictures to show me why. Thanks guys.